And at the same time, we're delivering new offerings that are built from the ground up to be iTwin native. And we're going to begin the tour with an example of exactly that. It's a new offering. It's an Electron app like Slack or Visual Studio, and it runs on the desktop. So it takes advantage of the local compute resources, and it's super responsive. But it also has cloud qualities, takes advantage of cloud services, and it's, for example, it's always up to date. And it's iTwin native, which therefore makes it data-centric, positioning it very, very well to take full advantage of AI. You ready? All right. Organizations in every industry are exploring AI, and as Nicholas said, infrastructure is no exception. And AI isn't new to users of Bentley software. We've been using it for years for computer vision applications, for asset assessment and inspections. But now we're entering a new generation of generative AI. So to talk more about generative AI and our newest offering for infrastructure design, please join me in welcoming to the stage Francois Valois.
Good morning, Mike, and thank you. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Canada. Bienvenue, Canada, my own country. So it's a real pleasure to have you here. It's amazing. In a sector facing resource shortage and, you know, a lot of backlog, you know, backing up, we need to use AI to really boost efficiency. We need to let professionals, you know, have the time to focus on the real challenges ahead of them. At Bentley, we see AI as a tool to augment professionals, not to replace them. Our strategy at Bentley is to connect infrastructure data with the engineering context to really elevate what professionals can do. The iTwin platform itself, as many have said before, is built around that, connecting a vast amount of data and allowing it to provide insights, connecting it to the context of engineering, applying logic to provide greater outcome to the professionals out there. So last year, we told you we were researching generative AI inside design. Remember that?
I do.
Yeah. And we've been working with a number of amazing partners that have been here to help us. And it's my honor to introduce one of the youngest of all, my good friend, Joe Viscuso from Pinoni. You can go your own way. You can call it enough. Welcome to the infrastructure, Joe. Tell us more about you and Pinoni.
Sure. I've always been passionate about technology. For example, when CAD was first introduced, I had a passion for it. And a lot of folks said it wouldn't work for civil engineers. And look where we are today, right? And my role at Pinoni is to leverage these new technologies, AI being one of them, to find ways to keep us at the forefront of these emerging technologies for better project delivery.
Yeah, that's amazing. So as we talk about using AI in engineering, Joe, what do you think about the current state of AI and the future of it in your domain? You know?
So I've heard it said that AI is like a teenager. It has good days and bad days, and I think that's true. But I think that we're finding amazing ways to use it. One of the ways, for example, is with road analysis. Road analysis in the past has been a very subjective analysis, eyes on the road. With AI, we're able to bring it into, to take videos, bring them into the algorithms, and create a very objective delivery for our clients.
And Joe, what are some of the challenges in site engineering specifically that you think generative AI can help with?
Well, I think we're having problems today with employees. It was said earlier, right? The industry is starving for employees, both at the graduate level and the middle management level. So to me, AI will provide the ability to do more with less, but actually do it more accurately at the end of the day. And I think that will be a big advancement for our industry.
Yeah, great. So Francois, tell us about some of the work that the team at Pinoni and the team at Bentley have been working on.
Yeah, absolutely. So my team and I have been truly, truly dreaming about building a product like I'm going to show you here today for years. It's just amazing. You got to love it. This is why I'm happy and excited and proud to introduce the OpenSite Plus. It's our next generation product built around digital twin and AI power. It goes from concept to final design. OpenSite Plus offers copilot experiences, site layout optimization, as well as automated drawing production, and much more. Do you want to see it?
Yes.
Yeah, let's see it. In this scenario, essentially, I'm going to have to design with you, hopefully, this hotel site around nearby the International Airport in North Carolina. So let's start. Let's start by looking at it inside our iTwin, inside the infrastructure cloud, so we can see the vast context where we have to work in. Now, flipping inside OpenSite Plus, we can easily create new projects, bring relevant data, informing that digital twin, including GIS data from Esri, Google Maps, and terrain information using open standard. In this project, we'll be incorporating 3D cesium tiles from the wall terrain, parcels from Esri, Google Map, building footprints from CAD files, and also the roadway design. So bringing all that data together easily. Now that the context is established, we can start designing. We will use the copilot to help us all along the way. We'll leverage our own organizational specific documentations to figure out whether we can do things in this area to help us really understand what's there and what's possible. Understand the context, if you like. So we can ask questions like, can I build an hotel in this area? Of course, easy, right? Gives you the answer. It reads the documents and figures this out. This is all within the secure copilot. With confirmation that, oh, and then also, by the way, it helps the engineer figure out where that answer came from. Understanding all that, we can start leveraging our next generation, very intuitive tools to start designing roadways, parking lots, buildings, and so on, to really quickly create our design. However, the copilot not only understands the documents, it also understands what we have in front of us, our design. So we can ask other questions. How many parkings do I have, and do I have enough parkings to meet my requirements, the zoning and my design requirement? So at this stage, we don't quite know whether our layout is optimal. So we built a neural network that is very powerful, looking at thousands of alternatives to figure out which one might be the best layout, optimizing our cost and also respecting our engineering requirements. So it provides these three options here, which are among the best, which I can apply to my design and use. But it's not all. Essentially, the copilot also can modify the design. So I can do all kinds of things, like change the parking width, the parking depth, and the angles, all that intuitively by actually talking to it, not only typing. This is just unbelievable, right? So notice also that I'm very polite with my AI because it gives you better results like that. I don't know why, but there's a little something that tells me I should be polite with AI. So joking aside, interacting with a copilot, and making automatic changes very precisely and easily is a game changer. Well, hold on. Okay, just time out. Okay, let's wait a minute. Do you realize what you just did here in a few seconds in front of you? So essentially, we did design, we validated it, we checked the context, and we made changes by talking to it. It's not a toy, right? You now have another way to input in the computer. It's just awesome. But it's not all. It's not the end of it. So OpenSite offers also AI-powered artwork optimization. So you can grade that site super easy and fast. It takes a lot of time before to do that. OpenSite Plus also simplifies the stormwater management. We need to know where that water is going to go in our site. So we've embedded our OpenFlows engine in this, right in there, to avoid data loss by transferring different softwares. And so it can model different types of things, like the ponds, the structures, and all of these complex objects super rapidly and easily. But that's not all either. Sorry. According to our key accounts, the next capability is the most powerful. Maybe a little less sexy than 3D and talking to a copilot, but the most powerful and the most useful. So now that we've essentially assembled the context, designed everything, we need to create our deliverables. Drawing production takes up to 50% of any site design project. That's a lot of time. We created a neural network that basically eliminates that task completely, make it seamless to do things super simply. The AI-generated text is essentially standard compliant, respecting legibility and aesthetics. This is not possible without AI, by the way. You need AI to do that. So it's instant, super fast, and instead of hours or days, the results are just unbelievable. And by the way, we're introducing that in OpenSite Plus, but we expand that in the future in other products. Just unbelievable. So in closing, the OpenSite Plus is our next generation product built entirely on the brand new platform iTwin. It provides a new level of productivity from concept to final design to digital delivery. Remember, we have a 3D model right there as well. And all of this is AI powered through the copilot, checking standards, interacting with it, using natural language, using my voice. Plus, it's automatic drawing. What else do you need, right? Pretty cool, right?
Well, I think it's pretty cool, but more importantly, Joe, what do you think?
Well, I think it's a game changer, right? The ability in the past for site design, we have to move from platform to platform. This will put everything we need in one platform, moving seamlessly through our drawing sets and creations, and I think that this will help keep firms like us at the forefront of technology, and again, more importantly, in project delivery.
Excellent, excellent. Well, Joe, thanks a lot for sharing your experience and your insights. And Francois, thank you and the team for the great work done here.
Thank you, and thanks, everyone.
So we're targeting a limited availability of OpenSite Plus. It's coming out very soon. If you're interested in participating in the Early Access Program, you can scan the QR code here and join that program, get an early look at it before it's available in the market. You should also keep in mind that OpenSite Plus is relevant for all infrastructure sectors. It's relevant for water, energy, transportation use cases, and it's a clear example of how iTwin native AI-powered applications will assist engineers and really, really help them with their work. And it's also just the first example of how Bentley Open Applications will take advantage of generative AI.